I'm Brendan from Circa Survive, and we're gonna take you through the Circa Survive rigs. So this is my main guitar. Gerard Melancon is a builder outside of New Orleans a little bit. He's closer to another city in Louisiana, but I can never remember. This is a Swamp Ash. I've been playing this forever now. I can't get used to anything else, really, to kind of create the same tone that I'm used to. So I think I'm gonna be here for a while with this guy. And then this guy over here, like, I don't usually like flashy guitars, but this guy just builds such pretty stuff that I had him do one of these for me. And I wanted to have something with a single coil, but this thing sounds nothing like anything I have. It just has like a much more hollow sound to it. It's chambered. And the funny thing about this guitar is when I first got it, it had like a actual, like a open body. I hit him up and I was like, man, I don't think this body is gonna work for me for what I do. And he literally just rebuilt a new body and sent it to me. Basically what I'm saying is this dude has taken care of me more than anybody in the business, and I really appreciate that. I'm 39, and this is the first Gibson I've ever owned, and I bought it this year. But there's just something about this thing. Love the color, and it has more of like a classic rock sort of tone than anything that I have. I only use this for one song right now, which it's probably not the best song to be using it for, but I wanted to use it for something. So I'm using it for like a really chill song, and it's just like screaming to be rocked on right now. So I guess we'll figure that out sooner than later. So this is Bad Cat Hot Cat 30R. It's a pretty simple setup. To me, it's like one of the best high gain sounding amps that there is right now. It like pushes a lot of mid-range, which I like quite a bit. So, been using this polytune pedal for a while. It's just a hell of a lot easier to see when you're outside than the other tuners I've used. Using this Catalan Bread Karma Sutra pedal right now for fuzz, for like a ridiculous fuzz tone. I don't use it very often, but it's a lot of fun. And I'm a big fan of using this MXR bass octave with a super high gain. When I use this with my amp distortion and throw this tube screamer on, it sort of cuts the low end just a little bit, so it has a really nice feel to it. It can cut. This is a Keeley modded tube screamer and a Keeley modded blues driver that I've had for a long time. This old Boss RV5 is still my favorite reverb pedal that I've ever had. It's always on the modulate setting for me. And then the Strymon pedals, the Mobius, Timeline, and Big Sky. I have so many pedals at my house that I use for writing, recording, and a lot of really cool pedal companies have hooked us up recently. Old Blood Noise and Walrus and Earthquaker have helped us out and sent some of the coolest stuff. It's extremely inspiring. But when I'm on tour, there's just no more convenient setup for me for what I do than having these pedals. Generally on the Timeline, I have almost all of our songs on here, and I use an A and B setting for each song. So I'll have like two delay settings, and then I can take, since there are 99 patches, I can take basically like the upper patches and go to the top 20 and just program the set that we want to play every night. So it's basically just super simple. This is the Empress Super Delay, which I've had for quite a while, and it's just a really clean delay effect that I love. And I kind of use that for if I want to have a secondary delay, like a reverse or something, or if I want to have trails going between songs that are super long, I'll kick that on over top of this. Then I can switch this to the next song while this is still happening. And this Durham Electronics Sex Drive is essentially a part of my amp tone. It's always on. Just adds a little bit of grit. And if I want to have a little bit of compression on a song, I can just flip that switch. But yeah, for now, that's what I've been doing. Pretty simple.